Fox 5 Health News. Noise pollution said to be the number one complaint among Americans about their neighborhoods. Now researchers are looking at how it could lead to heart disease.
Joining us now to break this all down is Dr. Clenton Coleman from Holy Name Medical Center in Teaneck, New Jersey.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Thanks for being here. So there is this connection, potentially?
Right. So the question is, does noise pollution increase your risk for heart disease?
Mm-hmm.
We know about the traditional risk factors of heart disease, which include high blood pressure, tobacco smoking, and diabetes. There is some evidence that...
Things that are in your control
exactly,
by some
right.
measure.
So there's some evidence that environmental factors or noise, like traffic noise, automobile noise, may increase your risk for heart disease.
Right, and this usually comes down to like the fight or flight, right? It
correct.
Stresses you out
correct,
hearing
correct.
All the chaos outside.
So this new study suggests that noise may induce a stress response, like you mentioned, increasing mm-hmm. your stress hormones, ultimately lead to vascular damage, and ultimately may lead to increased risk of heart disease. So it's important to know that this may become more of a public health issue as we get more information about heart disease and its relation to noise
right.
pollution.
Well, that's the case, and I think everybody in New York City should be
right.
concerned about this, especially
right.
if you live
nowhere
in Hell's Kitchen.
Here, right? You always talk about the energy you come to this city,
right.
Right. you get amped up, but you live here over time, it might take a toll
right.
on
maybe
you.
You're telling kids that, too.
Right, right. Exactly, right. Indeed. All right, makes sense.
All right, so now here's the other one. Can your cell phone give you cancer? A new government study tries to tackle the question that has been debated for many years. I thought we debunked this. I thought that that there was no connection.
I thought so, too. So, you know, cancer and cell phone use, we know cell phones emit this radio frequency radiation, mm-hmm. which has been linked to certain types of cancer, particularly head and neck cancer. This new study looks at rats that were exposed to high levels of cell phone radiation, much more higher than what we use from a day-to-day use. They concluded that these rats did develop some cancer in their cells based on the exposure of radiation. The most important point is that the radiation that the rats receive is not what we would use on a normal day-to-day basis. So this is an animal study. There was still no evidence that there are any human adverse events from cell phone radiation. So we should continue to use our cell phones as we normally do.
You know, people hear government study and they immediately think, oh, no,
right, yeah.
like this must be legit. This must be something that I should be really concerned about. But as a doctor, do you put much weight behind it?
No, because I use cell phones a lot, so
you know,
I'm exposing myself. Exactly. So, you know, just keep in mind this is a preliminary study.
Right.
The study was done in rats. It doesn't equate to our use. They use a much more higher level of exposure with cell phone radiation than what we use on a day-to-day basis.
Because this guy uses a cell phone a lot.
All the time, but so. You know, I don't use it as a phone.
That's
so
true. It's a personal computer.
Like this, yeah.
Good.
That's right.
All right. Dr. Clinton Coleman, thank you very much.
Thanks for
having me. We appreciate it. All right, Nicholas, what about the weather? We're just sort of in the